This one's for my dear sweet little baby cake. Maybe you're wrong and New Jersey isn't cold in the winter this long. Not to mention the humidity makes it all glow in a half drunk fog. That's just so wonderful. You might not.
Greetings. My name is Ian Vargo and I'm with theproaudiophiles.com. And today I am going to be giving you an introduction to drum augmentation and replacement. I'm going to be using the Massey DRT plugin and the popular virtual instrument BFD2. Drum replacement and augmentation is a controversial topic. There are engineers that say that if you can't record it right, then why replace the samples? It's a big thing, but the way that I look at it is if Roger Nichols, the engineer for Steely Dan, the man who popularized it, and put it into practice, if it was good enough for him, then it's good enough for me. So first off, I'm going to be using this song, Baby Cake, by the band Ugly Ugly Words. Check it out on iTunes. Have a listen.
This one's for my dear sweet little baby cake. Maybe you're wrong and New Jersey isn't cold in the winter this long.
Okay, so the way I like to look at replacing or augmenting drums is what are the individual sounds missing? Now, for example, I find that the snare in this song, which I'm going to solo and play right now, has a nice sort of crack and high end, but is perhaps missing some low end and some room and maybe some explosiveness. So when augmenting or replacing samples, I like to think about what the sound is missing and add it with additional samples. So first thing, I am going to take the clip of the sample, of the snare, excuse me, and I am going to go to Audio Suite, Instrument, Massey DRT, and we see this handy window right here. This is one of the easiest things in the world. I can't believe technology has gotten this far. I'm going to click Analyze. And what we're going to see is many, many yellow trigger points. Now, this is the demo version of the Massey plugin, and I find it works just fine. But I would definitely recommend Stephen Massey's plugins. Now, what we see is every time we have a transient, the plugin has created a yellow trigger point. Sometimes we are going to have too many trigger points. Maybe it will read a kick sound or a bleed from a hi-hat or something like that. But in this case, I think we're in good shape. Let's take a listen. So I'm fairly certain, and perhaps here, that we are in good shape and that the only trigger points that we are seeing are trigger points that we want to be converted later to MIDI data. It's even picking up the ghost notes. Wonderful. Okay, so we're going to select this whole clip and we have some options here. We can compress our triggers or we can raise the overall volume. So we're gonna do a little bit of each. And it's as simple as MIDI drag and drop, and I'm going to drag to an instrument track that already has BFD2 loaded upon it. Going to go to clips, going to hit Y, so it drags it to the beginning of the session. And now, every time that we have a snare hit, we also have a MIDI trigger point. Okay, so let's take a look really quick. And incredibly, not only does it create perfect trigger points, I'm talking pretty much sample accurate. Look at that. But it includes velocity data. So when we have those ghost notes, it can actually import that into the velocity information. Okay, so next step, I'm going to load up BFD2, which is a really great sampling software. going to load up a snare. Let's just go with this one, for example. And now the only issue is that perhaps the notes that we dragged from the Massey plugin are not actually at where the snare is located. So as you could see, it was set to where the kick was. So let's go over to notes, shift, and drag. There we go. I find that the BFD2 plugin runs a little bit hot, so you're going to have some distortion on your track. Let's drag it down a little bit. And now we have control over room, ambience. We could just use the overhead sound. So if you have a really close sound, but you want to add some room and some ambience, just use this. If you have a sort of roomy snare sound, you can just use the direct signal. And this plugin goes very deep. You could change the tuning. You could change dampening. And there are many other things about this plugin that are great. what I'm now going to do, I would, at this point, maybe put some effects, some EQ, some compression to sort of sculpt the snare sound the way that I want. And then I will come out of BFD2. And if I have a very direct sound, I will print it to a mono audio track. And let's just call this new snare. I like to put in signifiers. So, if it's close, I will type in close, or if it's ambient, I will type in ambient just so I know on the track. Let's just say for now, new snare close. And then I will very simply hit record and play. And that is recorded now as audio. So I could do this many, many times. And the result is basically whatever those snare and kick sounds were missing, I can add back in. In this case, I will go through and show you a couple of the different sounds that I used. So the original snare we have here, I added this sort of beefy snare sound, this roomy sound, and a very distant ambience. That's hard to hear. I'll turn it up. Same thing with the kick. So we've got this kick here. And I added sort of an upper mid-range type sound. And all together, really just helps reinforce the transience, and you can have a lot of fun by changing the style of the performance and the overall vibe of the sound. And I think drum replacement and augmentation is not cheating whatsoever. All right, so if you have any questions, make sure to contact me, and make sure to check out Baby Cake by Ugly Ugly Words on iTunes. And once again, this has been Ian Vargo with The Pro Audiophiles. Thank you.
This one's for my dear sweet little baby cake. Maybe you're wrong, and New Jersey isn't cold in the winter this long. Not to mention the humidity makes it all glow.